بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My brothers and sisters, just quick reminder. So many brothers and sisters, they complaining to us because they have nightmares, evil dreams, which affect their spiritual and also physical. And they become emotional and become tired. Some of them even scream during the night. Some of them, they get up and run. So they looking for solution how to remove these difficulties from their life. We have no doubt that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, send him rahmatan lil alameen, merciful for jinn and for the ins. Therefore, there must be a solution for that. Because we believe in alimul jinn. We believe there is a difficulties. There is a shayateen from the ins and from the jinn, which can harm us if we do not take precaution and if we do not use the tools which and the protection which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us. So, how can I remove and stay away from the bad dreams and the evil dreams? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he didn't left nothing without explaining. Regardless that which can benefit us, he explained it, and that which can harm us, he also told us how to stay away from it. So I will mention two hadith, and we can get some benefits of this hadith to see how can we protect ourselves if some of these things happen to us during the sleep. The first hadith Abu Salama ibn Abdul Rahman, which is in Bukhari and Muslim, he said, I heard Abu Qatada radiallahu anhum, he heard from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, الرؤيا من الله والحلم من الشيطان فإذا رأى أحدكم شيئا فلينفث عن يساره ثلاث مرات إذا استيقظ وليستعذ بالله فلن يضره شيء إن شاء الله. This hadith, my brothers and sisters, the Prophet told us, الرؤيا, the dream is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which means the good dream. But the evil dream, which is the nightmare, is from the shaytan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do not harm his creation. It's from the shaytan. What is the solution, Ya Rasulullah? He says, any of you can see this such a dream, or have a nightmare, he said, when he wake up, let him spit in the left side 3 times. Which means the spit, just the air, not the saliva, like 3 times. And then, make isti'adha. فَلْيَسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. Ask Allah Azza wa Jalla protection, a refuge from the shaitan, the evil, the outcast. Because his goal is to harm him, to give you difficult time. So the Prophet says, فَلَنْ يَذُرُّ شَيْءٍ inshallah. And that dream, bad dream, will not harm him, inshallah. Abu Salama radiallahu anhu, he said, when I heard this hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sometimes he said, I had the dreams which was more difficult and more heavy on me and the mountains on top of me. He said, but after this hadith I heard from the Prophet, I didn't care anything about, which means that he got removed the stress what he was having in his body. In some narration, Abu Salama radiallahu anhu says, I was seeing kuntu ara ru'ya hatta kuntu amradu min. I was seeing a dream, I was getting sick from it. And the dream, the nightmare was making me sick. He said, until I heard Abu Qatada, he said, it happened to me the same thing. And until I heard the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, a ru'ya saliha min Allah. فَإِذَا رَأَ أَحَدُكُمْ مَا يُحِبُّهُ فَلَا يُحَدِّثْ بِهِ إِلَّا مَنْ يُحِبُّ. He said, الرُّؤْيَا الصَّالِحَةَ, the righteous dream, good dream, he said, it's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you see something which you love, he said, do not tell that dream to nobody except the one who you really love. Which means, to be protected from the evil eye, from the jealousy, from the hasad. So the Prophet says, if you see something good, you see, for example, you see Jannah, you see the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or you see Allah has promised you something in dream, or something will happen good for you. He said, don't tell this dream except to somebody who you love. وَإِذَا رَأَهَا أَحَدُكُمْ شَيْئًا يَقْرَهُهُ فَلَا يُحَدِّثُ بِهِ أَحَدٍ. But if somebody sees something which he hated, he said, don't tell the dream to nobody. Protect yourself. Don't try. Maybe somebody can interpret that dream in a way which can happen and will harm you. Then the hadith goes on. فَلْيَنْفُلُثْ وَفَيَنْفُضْ عَنْ يَسَارِهِ ثَلَاثَ مَرَّاتٍ وَلْيَسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ وَمِنْ شَرِّ مَا رَأَى. He say then, when he, if he wake up, he say, let him spit in the left side, same thing, 3 times, and ask Allah to protect him from the shaitan and from the evil what he saw. فَلَنْ يَضُرُّهُ. And the hadith goes, he say, and that, if you do this, will not harm him. The hadith is Sahih Muslim, hadith Jabir ibn Abdullah radiallahu anhum. The Prophet sallallahu he told us same thing in the hadith. إِذَا رَأَ أَحَدُكُمْ فِي مَنَامِ مَا يَكْرَهُ. If somebody see in a dream something would hurt him or he hates him, he say, let him spit in the left side 3 times. And let him say isti'adha 3 times. And then he said, let him change his position. So we understood from the hadith some of the tips we need to do if we see some bad dreams or nightmares. But my brother and sister, we all know أن الوقاية خير من العلاج or أفضل من العلاج. To protect yourself is better and to cure it. That's what we learn from the doctors. So in this case, before we come to this, I just want to remind you, Prophet ﷺ told us so many ahadith and etiquettes, what we should do before we go to sleep. So he told us, make sure you sleep in a state of wudu. So you take this precaution, you make wudu. And then he told us to read the adhkar, bil-layl, al-ma'udhatayn, then suratul ikhlas and ayatul kursi. And you do this adhkar, and then you lay down in the right side. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we know the hadith of Ayatul Kursi and Wudu, Allah send you malik as a protector, as a guardian. Every time you wake up and you mention the dhikr, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the angels, they make dua for you. So you lay down in the right side. Even after the while you turn to the left, but at least you start with the right side. You start with wudu. Even if you sleep, of course, your wudu will be nullified, but at least you start with this. Alright? So in this case, you take this asbab, this protection, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect you from these nightmares and these evil dreams. But if somebody forgot, he got tired and he didn't have a chance to read the adhkar, and then happened to he see nightmares and this, then when he wake up, what he do these 5 things. 4 of them we took it from the hadith, and 1 is from the another hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What the Prophet told us, if you see a bad dream and you wake up, you first spit in the left side 3 times. Then you ask isti'adha from Allah azza wa jalla, protection from the shaitan 3 times. Yes, that's what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us. The 3rd one, he say you change the position to help me. If you was in the left side, you turn to the right, or if you right, turn to the left, or change the position in the bed. That's the Prophet ﷺ told Hadith Jabir. Then after that, the Prophet said, if that dream is bad dream, don't tell nobody the dream. This is the 4th thing we understood from the Hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. The 5th one, the Prophet ﷺ told us, because when the person falls asleep, the shaitan put three knots he tied behind his back, 3 knots. So every knot, the shaitan is saying, he tells you to sleep long, so you can wake up, nafsul khabith, nafs like a grouchy, tired, filthy. But he said, the Prophet say, somebody remembering yadhkurullah, in sleep, then the 1st one knot is being untied. Then, if he get up, and make wudu, the second one is bent untied. And when he get up and pray after the wudu, even the third one, well, he will be removed even from the third knot. And then the Prophet says, أَصْبَحَ طَيِّبَةُ النَّفْسِ. He will wake up, get up with a pure heart, happy. He will be able to pray the Fajr in time. So my brothers and sisters, this is some of the advice which Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he gave to his companions, and also he gave it to us as his followers and from his ummah. So we ask Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala to use this in our daily life, so we don't have a nightmares and we don't have a bad dreams which can affect you spiritually and also physically. We ask Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala to protect us from the evil of this worldly life, from the evil of the shayateen, al-jinn, and also from the shayateen, al-ins. هذا وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.